Today, we will be going over the quickest and easiest way to win Connect Four. It's called a combinatoric win, and in short, it means forcing your opponent into a lose-lose scenario. Identifying these positions is a learned skill, so we'll take a look at a few examples of how to pull them off. Here's a contrived example to show you what I mean. See how Red's pieces form the shape of a 7? Take a look at the two spots marked with a capital T, indicating a major threat. A major threat means that if Red plays there, it would win the game. But here's the catch. Since the threats are stacked right on top of each other, Red has already won the game. Let's see what happens. In reality, it doesn't even matter what Yellow does here, since Red will play in the 7th column regardless. Eventually, the first threat is revealed, and Yellow is forced to respond, blocking the lower threat. Then, since the second threat is immediately above it, Red plays on that threat, winning the game. This is a simple example of a combinatoric win, but it's intentionally constructed to give Red the advantage. Yellow would never play this way in reality. Let's see some realistic threat pairs in practice. Check out this example. It's Yellow's turn to play, and Red has some frightening threats. Take a moment to analyze the position for yourself before I reveal what Yellow needs to do to make it out in one piece. Most obviously, Red has two major threats on the second row. This means that playing in either of those two rows will immediately cost Yellow the game. On closer examination, there's also a minor threat on the first row, marked with a lowercase t. A minor threat is a set of four pieces with two empty spaces left to still be filled in. Let's say that Yellow ignores all of these threats. What would happen? Red can play at either of the two minor threats, revealing two simultaneous major threats. Yellow can't respond to both at the same time, meaning Red will necessarily win the game. So, Yellow has to block some of these threats. There's only one that can be blocked, do you see it? By playing in the 7th column, Yellow can disarm the paired threats and escape a swift defeat. This is an example from a super common opening called the Narrow 6-1. Usually, both players begin to build up a pillar like this. However, the last Yellow move was a mistake. Can you see what Red can do to attack? If you said Red should play here, you're right. Notice how this move exposes two major threats. So let's go back one move and see what Yellow should have done instead. Notice all the minor threats here? It turns out, as long as Yellow defuses any single one of them, it will be sufficient to escape the immediate danger from Red. I hope you enjoyed this brief Connect 4 tutorial. Consider subscribing if you're interested in seeing more Connect 4 videos. They might come slowly, for the time being, while I work out the kinks in the software I've been making to render this video, but I expect to be able to produce them increasingly easily when it's in a more stable state. I have a whole list of videos I have planned, so be sure to stick around. And definitely don't miss out on number 6, it will change your understanding of reality itself. This has been 2Swap.